So we're out this morning working with Bolt in an open park. There's usually a lot of squirrels here, so we can work on his leash reactivity and his excitement and impulse control. And then also, if we don't catch any squirrels around, we can just practice some good old leash work and some placement. Bolt, please. Boy, up, up. Good. Stay. Good boy. Got the GPS collar on him as well as a longer training lead. Good boy. It's pretty quiet for now, so we're just gonna practice some recall. Good boy. I know, big guy. Come on, let's go. Good boy. Yes, good. I want to give him some praise every time he comes back on his own. Good boy. And maybe every 3 to 5 times, we'll also give him a treat too. Definitely want to promote that good positive behavior, especially unprompted, because we're going to be trying to save the treats for when he is really distracted or pulling towards something. So he's got some trash over there that he's pulling towards. So Bolt, Bolt. Bolt, come. Good boy. And that's usually what'll happen. If he's still searching and interested in something else with his nose, kind of finishes and then comes back in. A way that we can work on a snappier response is by using his collar, since he is collar trained, right? And we don't know what he's got over there. We don't want him to get into anything. Bolt. Come. Good boy. Yes. All right. And with instances like that, you have the option of using either just a momentary to get his attention off of those smells, or continuous and then releasing when he breaks off the smell and starts coming back to you. So I'm gonna try to stay away from all this trash though. Just don't want him getting into anything and getting sick. I'm gonna try to go out this way, see if we can find some squirrels or anything. Trying not to activate any leash pressure. It's a little bit hard. There we go. So now he's further out. Bolt! Come. Good boy. Good boy. So he does really well with the fast response when he's not distracted with his nose. That's good. That's pretty normal. Good boy. We do our best to not get tangled up in the trees as well. At least he's responding well to the pressure when the leash is pulled. Bolt, come. Good boy. Very good. Didn't need the collar or anything there. Gonna start off doing more of this recall work in hopes, like I said, of getting him to a little bit more conditioned to responding when he sees a distraction like a squirrel. And then afterwards, we'll finish off with some heel work out here in this environment too. Okay. Only got the platform back there. I might just put it back in the car, but we'll see. All right, it's getting a little tangled up here. Good boy. I may swap to the flexi leash if I get tangled up a little bit too much. He's doing a good job of checking back in though. Bolt, come. Now we'll use the collar. Bolt, come. Yes, good boy. There we go. So we want to give him the opportunity to respond initially. Oh, we might have to follow that up with a stay. That's okay. As he gets more distracted with the environment and excited, and all the smells, can tell that his verbal command drifts off a little bit and then just needs reinforcement with the collar. Might have just been looking for a spot to mark. Oh my goodness. I don't want him to go. There we go. Bolt, come. Good boy. Wait. Wait. Good boy. Good wait. Good. Want him to keep some extended focus time on to me before he gets a treat instead of just ping-ponging back and forth. Good boy, good sit. And if we did go in the trails, I'll probably swap leashes for sure. Let's try to stay in this open area and see if we can find a few squirrels first before we move on. Good boy. May have to put away the placement mat if we don't see any. Good boy, yes, come. Yes, good boy, good heel. Heel, good. Yes, good, wait. Wait, good, yes, good boy. So especially if he does start walking nicely next to me, going to acknowledge that and reward it as well. I'll let him go. I'm just gonna walk as well, see if he just keeps up. Good boy. Good job, big guy. Don't want him to get tangled up, so we're gonna have to go around this with him. Yes, good boy. Make sure sure he stays out of the playground, doesn't go to the bathroom or mark anything in there. Bolt, this way. Good boy, good listen. Place. Good boy, there you go. Sometimes during the weekend, there'll be other people with dogs here as well, especially along the trails. Today, I think everybody's still at work.
I was hoping to
at least see some squirrels. Surprised we haven't ran into any. There you go, good boy. Let's go down this way, bud. Let's see if we can find some more. Good boy. Try to go around all the trash. Bolt, this way. Got some gentlemen there too. Don't want to disturb them. Bolt, come. Good boy. Didn't need the collar that time, which is good. Especially since there are people over there with food. Good boy. Let's go this way, big guy. Just gotta be careful around the grills and the picnic tables. With all the leaves on the ground, it's hard to see if there's any food there. Sometimes people leave bones from ribs and chicken wings and things like that. Want to make sure that he doesn't get into any of those. So here, leash pressure. Good boy, come. And so he's just tracking with his nose now, so we'll use the collar if we need to. Nope, he's back. Good boy. Good job. I want to record most of this in hopes that we get some good practice with running into a squirrel and distraction. Finish off with some heel work, but don't want to make too much empty video time if it's just going to be a lot of just normal recall practice. He's doing really well, though. You can tell it's mostly just his nose that we have to contest with right now. Make sure he's not getting into anything at the trash. Good boy. Bolt. Yep, good boy. I was trying to avoid that. It's okay, good boy. Got a car coming too, so I wanna make sure that it doesn't run out into the street. Bolt. Distracted by something there. Bolt, come. Go ahead and use the collar. Bolt, come. Good boy.
Some distractions here and there. I don't see anything major.
It's a trash truck. So go over sometimes why you would want a higher momentary, because this GPS collar doesn't have a boost function. So we can treat the continuous, or we can treat the momentary as a boost if we need to. Just keep it at 4 for now. Don't want him pulling us down the hill here, so bolt back. Come. Use the collar in that instance. This way, bolt. Good boy. Someone operating a leaf blower down there too. Good boy. Gotta go ahead and shorten up his leash. We'll work on some weight practice going down these steps here. I'll wait. Good. Wait. And kind of like with the same idea as heel, I'll give him a help or a correction if he goes past me. But we want, wait. We want him to get used to, hopefully that leaf blower isn't too loud.
We'll see if I can fix this.
We want him to get used to just slowing down and paying attention, especially downstairs. Good boy. Wait. So I'll take a step. Back up. So I'll take a step and then I'll allow him to, just like with the door control. Good boy. Wait. Good. Wait. 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 Okay. Good boy. There you go. Come. So I don't have his prong on, and I also have a bungee just because he has extra leash and the ability to build up a lot of momentum, so we don't want to use that. And I don't have an extra hand right now between carrying the camera too to use his collar. So just gonna use good old fashioned patience. Redirect him back up. Wait. I step down. Good. Wait. Good. Wait. Good. Wait. Good. Wait. probably can't even hear me because of the leaf blower, but he can still feel the pressure on the lead. Good boy. Wait. Good. We want to make sure that he's actually holding on his own. Good boy. Let's go. Before releasing him, we're not just holding him back the whole time. Oh, there's a pup up there. They're actually coming over this way too, so that's good. Good boy, come. See if we'll need the collar or not. He wants to go and play. So luckily I have it secured onto myself here. And what I'll do is, good boy, come. Come here. Yeah, wait, bud. Wait. Wait. Good boy. Wait. Good. Look at the pup. Wait. Yes. Much better. There we go. Oh. Good boy. Job. What do you think, huh? Good boy. Yes, good weight. And this is without the collar. Just needed a little bit of help with the lead there, so I just stepped on it momentarily, and then he's able to kind of control himself. Now what we'll do, instead of the leash pressure, good boy, we'll use the collar. Bolt, come. Good boy, wait. 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 Good boy, good wait. Hey, this way. Good, with me. Yes, good boy. With me, I know. Wait. I know, good boy. And that's how you would do it. You would just substitute the leash pressure with the collar. So the same time that you would normally add in additional pressure because he's passing you for heel. We'd use the continuous until he gets back or the momentary. Wait, good boy. And I'm gonna just reward him for his patience here and focus. Good job. All right, we'll let him go again. It's gonna be very important that you're careful. Good boy. Came back on the leash pressure. All right, you're careful when you're doing this so he doesn't get tangled up in the trees and you avoid any rope burn. This particular training leash has an additional attachment here that I can actually use to help reel him in and also to release. Good boy. He just wants to go and play with this pup over here. So now you can see his normal leash behavior is when he's excited, he hits the end of the leash and he can't get to it. Starts barking. Good boy, come. Wait. Wait. I know. It's okay. I don't know if they want to play with you, bud. Looks like he just wants to play with his ball. Come on, Bolt. This way. Good boy. With me. Oh. He's trying to do it with focus instead of the leash, but got tangled up. Good boy. Yes. Good boy. That was good. So I might switch, go back to the car, put away the placement mat and switch him on to just the Freedom Leash so I don't have to worry about all this getting tangled all the time and the extra slack. Good boy, come. Good boy.
Hi.
See if we can keep him into the heel just using the collar. Good boy, with me. With me, come here. Wait. Heel. Heel. Good, come. Good, heel, with me. Nope. Yes, good boy. Gonna use a little bit of the leash to help as well. Keeps overshooting because he's so excited. Right, with me. Good boy. Good boy, there we go. Yeah, really, I'm gonna go ahead and pause this and get the other leash to make things a lot easier. Keep getting tangled up on the longer line. Bolt. Good boy, yes. Good boy. Dang it. Well, this way. Good boy. Boy. Now we still want to do some longer range leash work with him, but now we can more easily either trigger leash pressure if we need to, or not have to worry about getting tangled up as much. He has a little bit less range, as this is only a 16 foot, that's fine. As long as he still responds well to the pressure and comes back. If not, I'll also use the collar. Come here, bud. Boy. Keep him away from trash. Come, Bolt. Bolt. Come. Good boy. Wait. Wait. Good. Job. All right, let's go. This way, Bolt. Make sure he stays away from all the trash there. Bolt, come. Good boy. Good. Good boy. Yes. Good boy. All right. man, still no squirrels around. I'm gonna go ahead and put the placement mat back. Do some walking either on the trail for some practice. We'll do the freedom first, and then we'll come back to the car and get his leash, or I might take the leash with me. And we'll do some heel work. Good boy. Once again, wanting to stay away from all the trash there. Good boy, thank you. Sure it didn't get tangled up there. It's gonna be a pretty heavy activity day for him before his crate work. And then it's gonna be raining, I think, either tomorrow or Saturday. So that way we'll be able to mix in more of a calmer day. Just doing some indoor drills, maybe with Leave It, and getting him used to going in and out of the crate. And see if the cabin fever and having excess energy plays a factor, whether it's easier or harder for him to stay in the crate and stay calm. Just trying to work on as many different things as possible. And like today, it's gonna be a pretty drastic change on things from Saturday. Both will be good to work with him on. Boy, yeah, I think I'm gonna save a trip. I'll just grab his normal leash. You can always just lock the freedom leash too. Normally prefer to just use a regular leash, but be one less thing to carry. So here, when he starts kind of pulling forward through the pressure, good boy, when we'll want to correct that to make sure he doesn't get used to just going straight through. Get out the collar here. All right. Bolt. Come. Good boy, yes. Good boy, there you go. Especially in a very distracting environment like this. All right? Good boy. Bolt, come. Good boy, wait. Wait. Got a car coming, bud. Good boy. Is he going around this way? I think he's going around this way. Come on, bud. Go this way. It's a good opportunity here for him to get really tangled up, so we want to try to prevent that. Wait. Wait. boy. I'm gonna go ahead and lock the lead so he can't go too far. And then as soon as he starts pulling on the pressure, we'll go ahead and correct him as well. Uh-uh. Boy, there you go. Uh-uh. No, boy. Get some leash work practicing. Uh-uh. Bolt. Good boy. There you go. Oh. Just gonna go ahead and warm him up since he's so distracted with the area. Do some directional changes. We'll also use the collar too. Good boy. Nope. Uh-uh. Good boy, okay. Good. There you go, good. Stay. Good, there you go. Just trying to get him to calm down a little bit. This is pretty understandable, especially in a new environment like this. Overstimulated and lots of smells. Good, good. All we're doing is just warming him up to focus and walk. Good boy. Yes. Heel, heel, good. Good boy, good heel. Good, heel. Good. Good boy. Oh, wait, yes. Very good, good job. So we're gonna do little bits like that at a time, and then wait. Give him a reward. He's remaining calm and composed here on his own. And now we'll go ahead and release him so he can walk around a little bit. All right, free. Good boy. And this is when you know the training part starts to kick in, because even when you release him, still apprehensive to run off and pull, which is understandable. You know, we took a lot of time and effort there, getting him to calm down and heal. Boy, but especially in an environment like this, we don't need it the whole time. We just need it for practice and to make sure he doesn't pull. Good boy. Boy. Good. It's hard to tell sometimes because the freedom leash almost always looks like it's taut. Bolt, this way. Good boy. Wait, thank you. Easy. Good boy, thank you. Definitely one of those times, especially going downstairs with loose leaves on them. You don't want him pulling. Be the end of the video real quick. He's doing well. Want him to be careful around the edge of the water here too. Good boy. Ball, come. Good boy. And that was just off of this verbal, so. Yeah, he's still, still a little bit iffy. Come here, bud. Ball, wait. Good. So throwing in that extra command once he gets close to having him focus and settle on you after he comes helps with him not overshooting and or just touching base and leaving right away. Good boy. Okay, go ahead. Trail is worn out. Wait. Boy, thank you. Bolt. There you go. Okay. We'll let him explore the trail a little bit, and then when we go back up, get ready to head out to the car, we'll practice a little bit more of that formal heel walk. Good boy.
Good boy.
Let's go this way, big guy. Boy. Oh, come. Good boy, let's sit back. Forgot to put on the bug spray in the car. God, I don't want to go too deep into the woods here. After these kind of hikes, no matter how short, because he's still getting into the brush outside, it'll still be a good idea to check him over for ticks and things like that. Okay, hold on. Going boy. All right. Got some other people coming along the trail too. Easy, big guy. Wait. Good boy. Good job. Little tangled up there, not too bad. Boy, this way. Just gonna use some leash pressure there. Bolt, come here, bud. Hi, how you doing?
Good.
Good. Good. Thanks. Hold on, bud. They might not like dogs.
No, I like dogs.
Oh, okay. Come here. Go say hi. Oh, good boy.
Oh, man, somebody's been good
in a little bit. A little bit. Yeah. Sorry. should have warned you.
No, it's fine. I'm used to it. I used to have a good lab myself. I love them.
Yeah, they're great pups.
How you doing?
Good boy.
How you doing?
Oh,
yes.
Good boy. Thanks, guys.
Have a good morning.
You too. Good boy. You wanna go explore this way? Alright, we'll do a little bit more exploring. No pull. Good boy, thank you. Always a little paranoid about stuff like this coming down on us, so let's not go all the way down, bud. Good boy. Good boy. Ready to go? And get you some water in the car too. You know, a lot of dogs have good enough stomachs, much better usually than our own. Can hold up here to drink river water, and this is, or creek water, and it's moving pretty quickly. I still prefer him not to, because we don't want him to risk getting sick if we can avoid it. Come on, bud. He's got the scent of something too. So this will be a good test of, oh, good boy. I was gonna say either his listening skills or good practice with the collar. So he's fine. Boy. Good weight, thank you. Good boy. Yeah, you're doing good. No pull. No pull. Good boy, thank you. Easy. Easy. See, I wonder if he sees something down there that's catching his attention, but luckily he's not immediately diving towards it, so that's good. All right. Easy. Nope. Oh. Oh, he's peeing. Okay. Just didn't want him to go all the way down there. All right. This way. Now we'll practice some heel going back in. Bolt. Heel. Heel. Good boy. Good. Heel. Good. It just seems to take him a second to get back. Good boy. Heel. Might lock the freedom leash to make it easier on myself. There we go. All right. Come on, bud. Good boy. Heel. 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 Good. Heel. Good boy. Heel. So a little distracted with everything. Nope. Good. Heel. Good boy. There you go. Good boy. Heel. Yes, good boy. Good boy, there you go, good. Not using any lead. Using a little bit there. Correcting, good. Good boy, there we go. Good. Goal is to not use any of these tools at all. Right, but good boy. It's doing really well so far. Good. I'm gonna do a turn and prompt the heel again. See how well he's still focusing. Bolt, heel. Yes, good boy. There you go. Come here. Got excited. Heel. Good. Okay. All right. Well, we won't push it. Goodbye. Good boy. All right. So nothing's being pressed or tugged on. Good boy. Very windy. Can't tell down there if that's another person with a dog or not too. Maybe once they start moving, or if that's just trash. I think that's a dog. There, we might go and practice a little bit of his leash reactivity again, especially since we have everything kind of set up for a heel already. And what we'll want to do is look for when he starts to pull or bark or react, and then correct them back in. Uh-uh, heel. Good boy.
There you go.
Good. Yeah, it's definitely a dog. I don't know if the camera's picking it up from here. Bolt. Heel. Good. Okay, so just resetting them a little bit. Heel. Good. Uh-uh. Good boy. It's actually a really good environment to practice reactivity like this because of his excitement, right? So the farther away that he is from the other pup, the more time that you have to redirect. Good boy. Keep him calm. Yes. Good boy. And then also I'll know right here, heel, boy. When he does start getting too excited, he starts to pull, right? Instead of focusing on me and sticking close to me. Heel. Good boy. Yes. She's picking up her pup. Heel. Good boy. Good boy. Heel. Good. Yes. And since they're walking this way, we're gonna go ahead and keep them calm and composed here, right? And then if he starts to react, we'll have plenty of time to correct him. And then if he stays nice and calm, then we'll just go ahead and give him praise and treats. Sit. Good boy. There you go. Brought some extended chew treats for him just for this reason.
Right. Oh, cute pup. Oh,
it's okay. Good boy. Oh, I know you want to play. Good boy. Good. Very good. Good job.
So you can see with a lot of setup work and prep work, we're able to get him to not overreact and start barking and pulling on the lead as well.
Good boy. I know you want to go up those stairs, huh? All right. Come on. Let's go back. Heel. There you go. Getting excited again. Heel. Good. Good. There you go. Easy. Good boy. No. Good boy. Heel. Heel. Too much. Good boy. Come. So just trying to help him out with some leash pressure. But then when he continues, good boy. We'll use the collar as well. Good boy. I'm trying to do it with good boy. But just focus as opposed to any kind of pressure. That's why it's a little bit harder. Good boy. There you go. Good boy. Heel. Good. Yes. Good. There you go. Good boy. Good boy. There you go. Good boy. Yes. Good boy. Good. Good boy. And then when he does it for a while, I have him stop again. Heel. Yes, good. There you go, good. Just doing it off command, trying not even to use the leash too. All right, bolt, wait. Good boy, good job. Good boy. Good. Good heel. Good. Good boy. Good heel. Good. Good boy, good heel. Here you go. Good job. The remote back in my hand.
All right.
Wait. Got a electric bike or something coming up fast. Wait. Good boy. Hi, how you doing? Good boy, good job.
All right.
Make sure at least. Gotta stay out of the way so we don't get ran over. Hey, heel. Good boy. Heel. Good. Good boy. There you go. Good boy. This way. Good. The pup is down there too. So I'll keep recording in case he gets excited with it, with seeing the puppy again. This way, big guy. Boy. Good boy, good heel. Heel. I know, it's hard. I know. Heel. Oh, and now they're barking at him too. Heel. I know. Hey, focus. Hey, up here. Up here. Yes, good boy. All right. Good boy. Good focus. Good. Good heel. Good boy. All right. Easy. You're just kind of smelling pee. All right, I'll go ahead and lock the lead. Good boy. Bolt. Good boy. Heel. Good. Good boy. Heel. Yes. There you go. Okay. Good boy. Good boy. Good heel. So now the leash is unlocked too. Good boy. Good heel. Bolt. Yes, good boy. Good heel. Little pup burst down there. Good boy. I know. Giving him a little bit of leeway in case I need to call him back. Hitting the end of the lead. Good boy. Yes, good boy. There we go. Good job. Good boy. Came back on his own. Well, he hit the end of the lead and then came back, but still without any corrections or being prompted. Good boy. Good job. I know, bud. That pup is too small for you to play with, too. I know. Don't worry. You'll have a big, big playmate tomorrow. Good boy. Bolt. Oh, tried to get him before he hit the end of the lead. Bolt, heel. There we go. Good boy. Yes. All right. Good job, Sid. Good boy.
Thank you.